Some people often say, it's either my way or the highway. That's an act of stubbornness. Welcome to today's DDRX. The prescription is choose your choices. Deuteronomy 30 verse 19, I call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you, that have set before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Therefore choose life, that both you and your descendants may live. Want to look at Abigail and Nabal, submission versus stubbornness. Submission is an essential quality of a Christian. It is the action or fact of accepting or yielding to a superior force or to the will or authority of another person. Note, to submit means you put others before yourself. It means putting God's desire above your desire. You can choose your own way or you choose God's way. Some people often say, it's either my way or the highway. That's an act of stubbornness. And we saw this in the life of Nabal. In 1 Samuel 25:1-29, you know, Nabal rudely refused David's request to field his 600 men. Verse 14 says, now one of the young men told Abigail, Nabal's wife, saying, look, David sent messengers from the wilderness to greet our master, and he reviled them. You know, out of stubbornness, Nabal refused the goodwill, the good request of David. But Abigail, a woman of good understanding and beautiful countenance, a submissive woman, interceded for Nabal. In verse 23, now when Abigail saw David, she dismounted quickly from the donkey, fell on her face before David, and bowed down to the ground. So she fell at his feet and said, on me, my Lord, on me, let this iniquity be. And please let your maidservant speak in your ears and hear the words of your maidservant. Please let not my Lord regard this scoundrel, Nabal, for as his name is, so is he. Nabal is his name, and folly is with him. But I, your maidservant, did not see the young men of my Lord whom you sent. You see, at the end of the day, David praised Abigail. In verse 32, then David said to Abigail, blessed is the Lord God of Israel, who sent you this day to meet me. And blessed is your advice, and blessed are you, because you have kept me this day from coming to bloodshed, and from avenging myself with my own hand. For indeed, as the Lord God of Israel lives, who has kept me back from hurting you, unless you had hurried and come to meet me, surely by morning light, no males will have been left to Nabal. So David received from her hand what she had brought him and said to her, go up in peace to your house. See, I have heeded your voice and respected your person. Submission pays. Choose submission over stubbornness. Thank you.